The number one movie over the weekend, G-Force. And if you're saying, what the heck is G-Force? It's because you're probably not a child or the parent of a child. It's about secret agent guinea pigs. They knock the Half-Blood Prince, which of course is the Harry Potter film, off of his throne down to number two.
Yeah, the Half-Blood Prince is in its second week of release. It took in around $30 million, banking a total of more than $220 million overall. And the Gerard Butler, Katherine Heigl romantic comedy, The Ugly Truth, took in $27 million in its first weekend in release. Well, two of those top-grossing movies, G-Force and The Ugly Truth, weren't as popular with the top critics.
Yeah, G-Force got a 19% approval rating among top critics who are on Rotten Tomatoes, while The Ugly Truth got a mere 11%. Yikes.
Crushing.
Remember, our Entertainment Weekly reviewer on Friday, also not a fan.
Entertainment Weekly said The Ugly Truth isn't fizzy and fun, it's vacuously snappy.
There you go. Back, but at least it's snappy.
It's snappy. Yeah, that's
that's
yeah,
usually a compliment.
I'm not sure what to make of that. Well, all right, let's see what the average viewer thought of it for a look at those films. We're going to check in with our iReport movie reviewer, Regime Gross, from Fort Thomas, Kentucky. Hey, Regime, great to see you.
Hey, how you guys doing?
All right, let's start off with The Ugly Truth.
How ugly was it?
Yeah, because we're looking at some of the reviews here, the Chicago Sun-Times, for example, saying the comedy bogs down in relentless predictability and the puzzling overuse of naughty words. Was it that naughty?
Oh, I love naughty words. What's puzzling
it
about
was,
that?
It was very naughty. Now, I guess the thing I'll say first, this was a romantic comedy that was funny. I don't know why these guys that, you know, work for these big places can't, I don't know, identify with us little folks that go to the movies, but I thought this thing was great. Gerard Butler plays the perfect male chauvinist pig who is trying to help Katherine Heigl figure out, you know, what the guy that she's actually interested in, what he's looking for in a chick. And along the way, you know, he actually starts to fall for her, which is not his intention, and, you know, you've got that type of story.
But I guess the critiques of the movie were that it's just a really tired plot that's been done a million times before.
Well, I mean, you've got all kinds of movies that are done and redone, and I think that this was, I think I put it in my review, I said that this was like the best movie I thought since The Hangover. I thought it was
that's saying a lot.
More of a, you know, female perspective of The Hangover than, you know, The Hangover was for guys. I mean, that was definitely a guy's film. Whereas this film, women can go to. The whole theater that I was at was probably about 50-50, men and women. Everybody laughed at, you know, the entire film from beginning to end, the same way they did when we went to go see The Hangover. And I didn't have a problem with this. I mean, everybody got their jokes, you know, everybody, you know, oohed and awed and laughed all at the same time. There wasn't any, you know, guys looking at women going, oh my God, you know, how can you be watching this? Or women doing the same thing for guys. I mean, the jokes I thought were great. You know, the punchlines were really good. I mean, it was, to me, it was a great film.
Yeah, you know, Regime, you raise an interesting point there about the predictability argument, because, as they say, there are only five stories, right? And we just keep regurgitating them and rehashing them in different forms.
I guess so. Right. All right, let's move on to G-Force. Now, this is really a kid's film. So, Regime, what were you doing there?
Well, actually, I have to tell the truth. I'm really only four, and I kind of sneak into these theaters on my own, you know, without parental consent. No, I'm kidding. I went because I've got a 12-year-old son. And not to mention that, you know, I try and go see all kinds of movies so I can, you know, give a good, honest review of what's out there, not just what I like to see.
So what did you think?
I thought this was a funny film. I mean, it was like Dr. Dolittle meets Mission Impossible. I mean, you've got these little guinea pigs that are talking to, you know, their team leader who, I can't pronounce his last name, but this guy you see on screen here. he's their team leader, and he, you know, they're trying to keep, you know, government funding for the research that they have, to where, you know, they've got this little organization where, you know, they get the guinea pigs, they've got some little roaches, believe it or not, even some flies, like you just saw in the last scene. You know, they're all secret agent spies with, you know, tiny, you know, micro technology, you know, cameras and microphones and things like that, and they're going out, you know, and trying to stop crime.
And hijinks ensues.
You know, they're out trying to quit, or end, rather, you know, world domination, you know, which is obviously a plot that's been done before, you know, with these little guinea pigs.
Which I guess are pretty cute, because I had a concern that people would rush out, as they have done with other cute creatures in films, and want to buy guinea pigs.
That's always a bad thing. Yeah, admire them on the screen. Do not go to the pet store and buy them. Yes, exactly. Regime, thank you for your reviews. Two thumbs up on both movies from him.
No problem. Thank you, guys.